Hello friends, welcome, and in this session I will discuss many important concepts. Start with the off budget liabilities or off budget obligations. So if we see this term has three words: off budget liability. Off means it is outside the budget. It is not inside the budget. Budget and liability. Liability means it's an obligation. It's an obligation which has to be paid by the government. Now, any obligation which has to be paid by the government, why it is not part of the budget? Why it is outside the budget? So, this is outside the budget because we follow accrual based system of accounting. Accrual based system of accounting, right? So what is accrual based system of accounting? So to understand accrual based system of accounting, we have to understand cash based versus accrual based. So this is cash based and this is accrual based accounting. Suppose in the month of April 2020, the government gets the bill of 100 crore rupees from a road contractor. Out of this 100 crore bill, the government pays in the month of April, suppose 40 crore, and in the month of May, only 50 crore, and in the month of June, rest 10 crore. As per the cash based accounting, in the month of April, 40 crore rupees will be booked as an expenditure, and as per the accrual based accounting, total 100 crore rupees will be booked in the month of April only. So in case of cash based accounting, we see how much is the cash transaction. So in this case, cash transaction in the month of April is 40 crore rupees. In case of accrual based accounting, we see how much is the total bill. So it might be paid in cash during this month or maybe in future, but this has already been billed, so this is due from the side of government. Once it becomes due, it comes in the same month. So in cash based, only cash transaction, and in accrual based, the due transactions are noticed. So here due basis and here cash basis, right? Now coming back to the off budget liability. So the off budget liabilities occur because our budget is prepared on the cash based budgeting. Our budget is prepared on the cash based budgeting, and there are some obligations which are due but not been paid. So those obligations might become part of the off budget liability. Now let us see an example. How does this work? So you might have heard about the term oil bond, and before I discuss this term, you might know that government provides fuel subsidy. How does this transaction happens? So the fuel subsidy is provided like this. Suppose we have the company Indian Oil Corporation. Indian Oil Corporation is a oil marketing company. So Indian Oil Corporation, the cost of per liter petrol is 100 rupees, and as per the government rate, the sale price is rupees 70 only. So it bears the loss of 30 rupees. This loss of 30 rupees is compensated by the government in the form of fuel subsidy. Fuel subsidy by the government. So this 30 rupees loss is borne in the form of subsidy. This subsidy is basically revenue expenditure as far as the budget is concerned. So in the budget, this is the revenue expenditure, because this does not impact the creation of asset and liability. Now, if this subsidy is paid by cash, if this subsidy is paid in cash, then this will become part of the revenue expenditure, and this will be included in the budget only, and it will be reflected in the revenue deficit as well as the fiscal deficit. But if in some year it is quite possible that government do not have the sufficient resources, if the government do not pay in cash but it allows issue of oil bonds by the OMCs, that is the IOC, Indian Oil Corporation, or it issues itself the oil bond for paying to the IOC, right? So oil bonds, either it can be issued by the oil company itself on behalf of the government, or government can itself issue these bonds, right? So the amount which is received from this bond receipts, they are received to the IOC, they are paid to the IOC. So these receipts are not coming to the government, because they are not received by the government, therefore they do not become the current year liability. So they do not become part of the capital receipt, that is, they are not included in the borrowing of the current year. Because our budget is prepared on the cash basis, but in this particular transaction, the government has not received the cash. It is the oil marketing company, IOC, which has received the cash. Because the government has not received the cash, therefore it is not reflected in the budget of the government. Therefore it is not reflected in the deficit also. So it is not impacting the revenue deficit, because it is a revenue expenditure. Despite that, it is not impacting the revenue deficit, and despite it is capital, it is the borrowing, it is not impacting the fiscal deficit also, right? So overall, it is not impacting the deficit also, but in future, this is to be repaid by the government only. So the central government has to repay the bond amount to the bondholder, as well as on an annual basis, it has to pay the interest. So it is the obligation of the government only. But this obligation is not in the current year. This will be paid in the future years. So whenever it will be paid, it will be reflected in the balance sheet of the government. That is, it will become part of the budget of the government, and it will be reflected in the deficit. So this situation happened when during the UPA government, the oil prices were rising very, very high, and the UPA government issued oil bonds. Now in the recent couple of years, in 2017-18-19, the present government repaid the bond holders amount which were issued during the UPA time. So at the UPA time, it was off budget liability, and during the NDA time, it became part of the deficit. So this is one example of the off budget liability or off budget obligation. Another example can be, for example, in case of food subsidy. So if in any year the Food Corporation of India does not receive the money from the government can allow the FCI, Food Corporation of India, to issue the bonds on its behalf, and in the future these bonds will be repaid by the central government. So this can also become part of the off budget liability. There is another obligation which can become part of the off budget liability, that is contingent liability. So what is contingent liability? Contingent liability happens when central government gives the guarantee to someone that I am guaranteeing you, if you give loan to this person and this person do not repay loan to you, then I will pay on his behalf. So this guarantee can happen. For example, central government says to the RBI that please give loan of 10,000 crore rupee to UP government, and if UP government do not repay, then I will repay your amount. So normally it is not the obligation of the central government, but in
case UP government fails to pay, then because central government has given the guarantee, so central government, for the central government, it will become the liability of that particular year. So the liability is contingent upon whether the UP government is able to repay the loan in future or not. That is why this is called contingent liability. So in the contingent liability, we can have the items like oil bonds and contingent liability. Now let us see in terms of language. These liabilities arise not because of borrowing or use of public money by the government. So government has not borrowed the money directly. These are money liable to be paid to the government to various entities as a policy matter. For example, government does not allow oil marketing enterprises to raise prices when the price of crude oil rises. To bear the losses to these oil marketing companies, it issues interest bearing bonds. These are not considered in the calculation of the deficit. This is very important. You have to keep this in mind, that they are not considered in the calculation of deficit in the budget, even though they are borrowed expenditure. This is called off budget liabilities. So this is all about the off budget liability. I hope the concept is very much clear to you.